Welcome, beautiful souls, to a new video of Ascension Wisdom Channel. My name is Emilia and I feel guided to record this video, sharing my insights about our next year. It is one of those strong calls, and usually when I have this, I start writing, and just in a few hours, everything is so perfectly arranged, and then I know that this is the message that it is important to be shared. Dear ones, are you aware of the obvious cross path that humanity is standing in? We are in a place in our evolution as a species in which we need to make a choice together. That choice can be made from the core of our being, trusting the divine spark that we are. And by doing this, the result will be total freedom, love and abundance and peace. Or the other option is to choose from our illusionary self, from the fears that the matrix is selling us. And this will result in living and attracting more fears and more suffering. In the next month, humanity will take a decision, conscious or unconscious, and a separation of the 3D and the 5D worlds will be made. In the next month, humanity is choosing if to continue feeding the fear scenarios by doing the vaccine, or start connecting with their inner divinity and say yes to love and freedom. The matrix system always kept us separated from our inner beauty, from our inner majesty, making us think or feel that we are unevolved, not important, not loved, making us feeling guilty that we are destroying our environment, that the pollution is because of us, and all the blame is pushed on humanity. But if you are looking close, why the government doesn't allow free energy to people? Why we are still not using Tesla technology? Why they are keep pushing us to buy technology that is so dangerous for ourselves? Why? They are constantly creating problems, and then they want to come with a solution that is beneficial only for them. If the so-called leaders of this world will have empathy for humanity and will want humanity to expand their consciousness and to grow, we wouldn't need money because we will be able to manifest. So why are you still closing your eyes? Because it is so obvious, their agenda. It is in our faces what they are trying to do, and it was always in our face. And I feel like humanity is under a spell and we cannot see it, most of us. We cannot see and feel the obvious. When you open your eyes and you see how many so-called weapons they use against our spiritual evolution, you start asking why. Why they are so afraid of us. Why they are attacking so badly when we raise our vibration. Why they are polluting our air, our food, our water, our souls. Why they did start creating this various scenario, making you think that a solution for a better life is the vaccine. Why they are adding more and more and more chemicals with every year that is passing in our foods, in our water, in the air. Why? why the solutions for the problems that they are creating are beneficial only for them. Because within us, in the core of our being, we have access to the infinite God's abilities. Once we start to create with the source of our being and raise our vibration, we become powerful. We become gods of light and love in this physical reality, and we are bringing those qualities of God in this reality. And they don't want this because it will be game over for them. They want us to separate from each other, from our souls, from God, from within, because like this we can be played through fear. We can be manipulated, feeling worthless, creating sickness and fears constantly. And this is what they have done for thousands of years. They are well informed about the cosmic laws, about how this universe is functioning, and they are using them into their advantage, manipulating realities. They know a lot about how our minds are working, how the subconscious mind can be programmed, how to make people obedient, and so on. They are keeping away from people valuable information by keeping people busy with outer and useless goals, so they can gather when it is an important celestial event, using that energy to their advantage. One thing they don't know, and they are always trying to keep us away from, is love. Love is our advantage and was always our advantage. One of my favorite hobbies since I was a child is to watch people. I can stay hours to watch people. Organic people with organic emotions and behaviors. People from the street, from parks, from everywhere. I learn so much while watching them, and when I see them smile, speaking with each other, my heart is opening. Often I say to myself, how beautiful, how pure and naive and perfect we are. I can feel and see the pureness of each soul. We are like children, pure and naive. We are so compassionate with each other, so happy when we meet with our friends, with our dear ones. We are so in love, with kindness, with goodness, so pure. When I watch people, I see the goodness of us, and I say to myself that this is what they want to take away from us. But they can never take the goodness out of us. They can make us feel low, not important, depressed or sad until we say enough. I am a divine being of love and my identity is love. I am an eternal part of God and I choose to live in a world where love is the core of every principle and law. Something powerful is happening with you when you start identifying yourself with that of what you already are. An eternal being of light. You go out from the victim role where you think you cannot do anything and you go inside. You connect with your soul and from that place you start praying. You ask assistance from God, from the angels, from the higher realms, and you start feeling self-empowered by taking your life in your hands trusting that you are loved and guided all the way. Only when we are disconnected from our inner center and out of balance, we become sick physically, emotionally, mentally, or we are in danger because of the law of the resonance, we are attracting those scenarios until we say enough. Starting with December 21st, we move into a new cycle named by so many the Aquarius Age. We start an era where we will start building a new society, a community created with high qualities of source. But before doing that, the truth must be exposed. The truth will reach each person, and collectively, we need to integrate, accept, and forgive ourselves for allowing all that to happen. And forgive everything and everybody is the key. Humanity must discover the truth of what was happening on Earth for thousands of years, because the truth will set us free. Once we start discovering that we were played and manipulated for almost all our history in all our civilizations, we will start saying no to enslavement, to lies, to corruption, to archonic consciousness, and we will start taking our lives in our hands, becoming self-responsible and self-empowered, connected with God from within. The previous era was an era of water, which can be a representation of the collective unconscious mind or the collective unconscious storage. And now we moved into an era of air, which can be a representation of the conscious mind. Therefore, all the unconscious things will become conscious. At the beginning of Pisces era, beautiful souls reincarnated on Earth to plant seeds of God aspects in the collective unconscious mind of people, and those seeds are still growing, becoming beautiful trees now. Just a few beings connected with God from their center had the power to anchor so much love into the collective unconscious mind. A love that is still present and growing in our days. This is the true power of humanity. Imagine in what world we can live if collectively we choose to create a reality based on love, compassion, freedom, and abundance. Just imagine. Spread the message of kindness, of beauty, of love, and see people as part of you, as part of everything that exists. Watch people in their eyes, because when you watch them in their eyes, you will see yourself. You will see the pureness of God, because this is what we truly are. And they succeed for thousands of years in making us think that we are less than that. Now it is a time for us to start identifying ourselves with our true essence. Another thing that I would like to mention is that I know that many of you are struggling now with fears of surviving. Because of what is happening in the world, we are financially affected. And I want to share with you a few light tools that can help you unlock your manifestation process. If you go deeper into fear, you will attract more fears, and this will result in blocking even more your abilities to manifest. Some of us have more free times than the others, and we can use that in our advantage. For example, myself. Daily I meditate. And after I breathe consciously for a while, I connect with my inner self, my center self, and with source through feelings of gratitude and love. In that state, I send energy, love, and gratitude into my chakras, especially into my lower chakras, where most of the surviving fears are stored. And I am speaking with them, telling them that they are divine aspects of God. If I notice or feel blockages, I ask the higher realms. And for me personally, I work with Archangel Raphael simply because I feel a strong connection with him. But you can work with any spiritual guide that you feel a strong, unconditional love connection. And I ask him to purify the blockages or the fears created. And then I visualize and see my chakra spinning clockwise faster. And I start breathing in each one of them, expanding them, telling them that they are divine. In each of the chakra, I visualize and feel the energy of that specific chakra. For example, in my root chakra, I see myself there, sending love and the message that I am open to receive abundance. I deserve to live in abundance. I trust God's plan. I am safe. And this is something that I am doing daily, and the results are wonderful. And you can do it. We all can take a minimum of half an hour from our lives and start working on our inner world, because we will manifest that in our outer reality. I am announcing as well that I created a package of 6 Ascension Wisdom classes. Each class is having a powerful transmission for the expansion of the heart and the activation of our chakras with the help of our beloved Mother Mary and Archangel Raphael. The package will be launched on my website and different social media platforms next month. Stay tuned and be blessed in the name of God.